Hi everyone, Grant K here for the Flame Premium Learning Channel. In this video, we are going to look at the different functionalities available when combining multiple Gmasks in a 3D shape. There is actually nothing to stop you from having as many Gmasks in a 3D shape as you like. The main point is to remember that we are still dealing with one 3D shape that is a combination of multiple Gmasks. So let's start off in action and create some 3D shapes. I want to do this differently so that you're aware of the multiple ways to create 3D shapes. Using a dual view split, ensure you are looking at the action node bin. Double-click on the 3D shape node to add it to the composite. If you want freehand drawing, then you can start clicking straight away. If you want more controlled shapes, try this. Delete the axis and the Gmask attached to the 3D shape. Select the 3D shape so that it will be the recipient of the new Gmasks. In the action node bin, double-click on the Gmask ellipse. This is now connected to the 3D shape node. In the center of the result view, click and drag a circular shape. Switch to the 3D shape menu and set the depth to 50. If you haven't already done so, go to the action node setup menu and enable shading. So that is our first shape. To add the second shape, go back to the action node bin. With the 3D shape node selected, double-click on the Gmask rectangle. Next, create the rectangle from the center of the circle. Instantly, the rectangular shape cuts a hole in the circular 3D shape. This is the first behavior when combining multiple Gmasks. This is called intersection. You can see the combined behavior when you look at the basic menu of the 3D shape properties. Press O to switch to the orbit mode and move the camera around the 3D shape. By intersecting the splines, the 3D shape is generating geometry with a proper hole in the middle. If I select the axis of the rectangle and move it around, you will see it cutting the 3D shape and the geometry is being generated live. So if you were to create any animation with these splines, you could create very intricate motion graphics in this context. The next spline combination is Union. Go to the 3D Shape Basic menu and change the pull-down menu from Intersection to Union. This mode combines all the Gmask splines into a single 3D shape. Moving the camera around again, you will see that you have one single complete piece of geometry. To make this clearer, I'll turn off the wireframe icons with I so you can see the 3D shape. The last spline combination is Priority. This is the most flexible means of combining splines together. With this mode, you can define each spline's behavior as well as what spline has priority over the other. To make this clear, I'll add another circular Gmask to the 3D shape. Now go back to the selected 3D shape menu. With priority, there are two functions you decide. Firstly, by selecting the Gmask node, you will see the Gmasks menus. Here, you can decide whether the selected Gmask will combine with the other splines, or it can cut a hole inside the 3D shape. Just by experimenting with the splines hole option on the different Gmasks will result in different combinations. So by only having the last circular Gmask set to spline hole, this shape acts as a cookie cutter through the other two combined splines. The second function of priority is to decide which spline or splines will be affected by the spline hole. Click the priority button. Now you can toggle between Action All Objects or Action Gmasks Only. Using Action Gmasks Only, you can see the spline's priority in the list. It uses a top-down priority structure. The top splines have preference over the bottom ones. So the last circular Gmask is at the top of the priority list. This means it will cut through both splines. If you push the circular spline to the middle of the list, it will only cut what is underneath it. So the rectangular spline is unaffected because it is above the circular Gmask. The main circle is still underneath the small circular spline, therefore it still has a hole. Ultimately, you choose which splines can selectively influence the other. Now I would like to spend a bit more time on the hole option in the Gmask spline menu. To set this up, I'll delete the second and third Gmask. I'll also set up the 3D shape spline combination back to intersection. Going back to the action node bin, I'll add another Gmask spline to the 3D shape. This time, I'll draw a small shape that intersects with the circular spline. So by default, when one spline intersects with the other, you get a resulting hole on the intersection. However, you are still left with geometry where the splines do not intersect. If you just want the spline to act as a cutting device, then just enable the spline hole option. If you orbit the camera around again, you will see how it is cutting the 3D shape. So the spline hole function allows your spline to behave differently from the main 3D shape settings. To conclude this video, you can use the 3D shape and the splines in combination with other action tools. As an example, I'll reset the camera to look at the 3D shape straight on. I'll go to the action node bin and drag out a replica node. I'll insert it between the 3D shape node and the axis node of the small Gmask spline. Going into the replica properties, I'll set the number of replicas to 8. I'll also drag the Z rotation to 45 degrees. So I have replicated a shape multiple times, which is cutting the main geometry. I'll also go ahead and add another circular Gmask to the 3D shape. So by doing a few quick operations, I have created a 3D cog geometry. This is a very quick example of how you can take basic shapes as well as freehand shapes and combine them together to create something more complex. And don't forget, you can still animate all these properties to create some really interesting and unique geometry. I hope this has got your creative juices flowing. Coming soon, we'll take a look at the profiling functionality, which will enable you to sculpt your 3D shapes in a variety of ways. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Premium Learning Channel for future videos.